What's going on, everyone? Juice Bags here, and welcome back to the channel once again. As promised, Chromatic gave up the goods and gave us another Dungeon Defenders Awaken news update today for August. Now, this was, in my opinion, probably the most informative update yet. It had lots of good stuff in it, and most importantly, it answered some of those big questions like dates. Not specific dates, but generalizations. Now, as most of you already know, Dungeon Defenders Awaken was featured on the Indie World Showcase from Nintendo UK just this morning. I will have a link to that full stream down in the description below. It also includes info for a lot of other just awesome looking indie games, so by all means, if you have a little extra time, watch that stream. There's lots of good stuff coming, and certainly well worth the watch. Now, one of the big things that was revealed on the Nintendo UK Indie Showcase today was that Dungeon Defenders Awaken is going to release in February 2020. Now, in addition to that, it is going to be a timed console exclusive on the Nintendo Switch. Now, what this means is in February 2020, Dungeon Defenders Awaken will release on the Switch and on the PC, as it is a timed console exclusive. Now, shortly after that, it will be coming to PS4 and Xbox One. I know a lot of folks are going to be a little bummed about that, but hopefully we don't have any dates or any kind of time frames yet. Hopefully it's not a large gap between the PC Switch release and the PS4 Xbox One release. Now, this was the first thing discussed in Chromatic's blog post, of course, and I'm just going to read it right to you. Why is it not releasing in October 2019? The TLDW, or TLDR, would be, the game won't be ready then. However, the words of wisdom are, Dungeon Defenders Awaken is meant to be a showing to our loyal fans of what we're capable of as Chromatic games. This isn't a simple remaster remake, but bringing back the soul of the original Dungeon Defenders into modern day. Building the game from the ground up is no simple feat, and we're pulling out all the stops to really blow your socks off. Half of the maps in DDA are new, assets in the game are new, all of the UIs are new, and a slew of new features to make for an enjoyable experience. Releasing in October would lead to two things, an unpolished and unrefined gaming experience, or tons of crunch that can burn out developers. As a studio, we absolutely refuse to release DDA as half-baked, and as a business, we don't want people working unbearable hours. I think that's all a pretty fair statement. As I mentioned, I'm just as excited to play the game as you all are. However, I want to play a game that's good to go, and I don't want to play a game that is not good to go. We've all had our fair share of unpolished games in the past, and let's keep some of those unpolished games out of our future. Now, they continue to go into this, why February 2020? In short, it's the best time to release the game. There's a multitude of reasons. We're able to keep cranking out the content without overworking and breaking our developers. We can release a beta that allows us time to make iterations as they're needed. We don't have to compete with AAA releases that would drown our marketing efforts. It's after the holidays, giving Defenders a chance to get back to post-holiday life and get hyped for DDA release. Now, this brings another important aspect, and that is the beta. Now, previously, they said that it's going to be a very short beta prior to release. It does appear it's going to be a much longer beta now, and we are going to get our hands on the beta in early November 2019. So, just in a few months, we're going to be playing the beta on PC, and then the full release in February 2020 on PC and Switch, with PS4 and Xbox One following shortly after that. Now, in addition to this information, we did get some really awesome animations. I tried to clip the animations. Sadly, they didn't come out and looked very well. I don't want to degrade the images any, so once again, there will be a link in the description below to the full blog post, and you can head over to the Dungeon Defenders website and check out these different Squire attack animations. One of the biggest things I can say is one of my concerns, based off of the character models we had seen so far, is it kind of looked like that it had that stiff upper body movement from Dungeon Defenders 1. Anyone who's played Dungeon Defenders 1 knows what I'm talking about. The characters ran around. There wasn't a whole lot of movement in their upper body, like from the waist up. That is definitely not the case, and these animations show it off quite a bit. And the Squire's actually got a really cool little jump spin move, too. He's still wearing his Crocs. I do have to call him out on that. The Squire is a Croc-wearing boy. There is no doubt about that. Now, in addition to these animations, we also got some looks at another map that isn't Deeper Well. As those that have been following along with the development of DDA, we've gotten quite a few images of Deeper Well, but we haven't gotten much else. Now, this time around, we got images of the alchemical labs, and I am able to share those with you here. They look pretty solid. There is notes saying that the core is supposed to be right in the middle there, but they took it out so that you could see all of the detail in the map. There's several different images of alchemical labs, and it looks pretty darn good. I can't wait to jump in and give it a play. There's no doubt about that. Now, in addition to that, we also got some images of our tavern. Now, this looks like it is modeled off of the DD1 tavern. It's got the same layout as the DD1 tavern from what we can see in this video, or pardon me, in these images, and the images are still a little plain. Obviously, there's some work to go on putting all the bells and whistles on in the tavern, but it is definitely coming along quite nicely for certain. Then at the bottom, we got some of the concept art of the new Demon Lord boss. That's one of the great things that DDA is going to bring back to our world, is lots of boss fights. Just like we had in DD1, I'm excited to hop into those in Dungeon Defenders Awakened. Now that is it for now. A lot of good info. February 2020, we got a November beta. We got some new Squire animations. We got some new map images of Alchemical Labs and of the tavern, and looking forward to see what comes next. So that will do it for now. Thank you all so much for watching. Make sure to click that like button, please subscribe, and let me know down in the comments below what your thoughts are of this Dungeon Defenders Awakened news update. So thank you once again, and I will see ya next time around. Take it easy.